When that video starts up and I get you guys every week, which I'm recording, as you might have seen earlier today, I am really happy because I'm on the other side of it. As soon as it gets on this side of me, I'm just like, I can't breathe.
We love you, David.
For those, I guess, who don't want to talk, do it because I hate yourself. I don't like yourself. And I just want to say thank you, Harry, because he's the guy that goes, you know what? Just be a bit more vulnerable, baby. And that really makes me scared.
We like vulnerability, darling.
Okay, so that's why I hide behind computers. But I do know that this stuff matters. I want your businesses to work. I want them to be found. I want you to be expert in whatever field you've chosen to be in. Because I want to be the expert in this field. And this field does touch your lives in so many ways. You can make your business grow through Google, even though people say, nah, it's all word of mouth, it's all that sort of stuff. It's not. People still use the internet, they will continue to do so, and it'll become even more. How many people talk to their phone and say, hey, tell me something? And Siri or whatever, it's Alexa or whatever, says, yeah, here's your song, or, you know, here's a bit of information. People doing that at the moment?
Yeah.
That's going to increase 50% easily next couple of years. We're all going to be using voice search. So one of the things I like to do is make sure your website's found. So this video is running in the background here. It's a presentation I did with for the business meeting last week, or week before. And it's basically just going through what I do. So I look at your website and go, okay, is your website viable? Is it even a candidate? Does it even stand out? Has it got credibility? Does Google like it at all? Because there's a billion websites out there. What makes yours special? Why do you found anyway that anything that you get promoted, want to be promoted for? So number one, does Google like you? And Google's a technical beast, so it's got software in the background that checks things out. And it's checking a lot of things out. No way can we game the system like we used to be able to do. Now the AI, the artificial intelligence, is so strong that it just knows everything and we cannot keep up. And it's learning by itself. Machine learning is happening. So whatever we do is going to change in the next couple of minutes. And so it's real time now. So if I rank you, it's instant. It's not like wait 6 months. So what's going on here is pretty much, I was just checking to see if a website was found. And it was, worked really well. And what I wanted to do, actually, just going back a bit. I'm going to go back a few slides here. So I wanted to say, you need to claim your site. See, at the moment, Google's collecting stuff around you. Where you are, all that Facebook stuff we did this morning, Google sees the public side of that. Can't see the private stuff that needs a password, they can see the public stuff. So any posts that go out there, your name can be connected to anything on Twitter, anything on Instagram, anything on Pinterest, anything that's publicly accessible, Google has already compiled information about you. So it's really useful that you claim that, that you say, that's me, I own that stuff. And if you don't, well, you pretty much leave yourself open to being, well, you know, spammed, abused, taken down. So do you want that through business? No, obviously not. You don't want people breaking the sign and stealing the sign in a shop. You want to claim that sign, you want to make sure it stays in place. So that's one of the things that you need to have up front before we do anything else with you. I refuse to work with you if you go, no, I don't need that. I don't need a Twitter account. I don't need a Pinterest account. I don't need a LinkedIn account. I don't need a Google Bim account. I don't want a Gmail account. I don't want to even buy a Gmail account, like the paid one, because if you do, Google likes you more because now you have a credit card attached to it, and a credit card gives you trust, and that's what this key thing's all about. Mm. Way back in the day, Google started off with the premise of they were going to be the website. Their mission was going to be to control the world's information. How they sold that was to say we want to organise the world's information. And when you organise something, you're going to collect information about it. So if you guys want to be in this room, we make you fill in a form. So we organise you. We collect data about you. Now we have a bit of control over you. We can send you emails. We can keep track of what you're doing. So Google does that by giving you your website. And in effect, creating what's called an entity. So an entity is just a thing, a place, or an item. And so you're now an entity in the Google world. You've been given an ID number. It's called a machine ID. And that's tracking you wherever you go. Facebook do the same thing. And you can find your IDs, it's a public piece of information in that sense. But because of that, we can track everything about you and so therefore, that's why this validation of your brand is so important, because if you don't validate yourself, you're just opening yourself up. Anybody can claim your ID, in effect. If you think of it like that, there are some safeguards, so be aware of that. So what I do, again, you validate your brand, make sure you own it.
Yeah.
You then get to amplify it by saying, okay, you've got your Pinterest, you've got your Twitter, your blah, whatever social media of the day it is, and we start collecting information, putting it on those places, putting it back to your site. So it's like a ring around your site, think of it that way. And so Google's going to these other places and going, oh, cool, I've got some really cool, key, and relevant information about you and your brand, and it starts to build a picture of you. So when someone's searching for your services, now you've got a level of trust and confidence with Google, it's having to offer you as one of the first 10 results. Or maybe two of the first 10 results. Or three. Because you've got Twitter, got Facebook, got LinkedIn, three results.
Yeah.
You've got YouTube, five results. So there's lots of ways of doing that. So I run what's called a Google Health Check. I charge $300 for that. What that does is give you an overview, a snapshot of where you are, what you can do, what you need to do. Because you may be fine. You may be like one thing you need to get done properly. But then that can lead to a strategy where you can, okay, promote your brand out there. Because at the end of the day, if you don't, someone else will. It's that simple. You might get to the top of the number one position for your key term, and then other people will start to push you down because they want that as well, because there's money attached to that term. So yeah, here's some obvious stuff you need to do. Lean in fast, get yourself owned or pwned, which means you've been taken over. It's a gaming term. And then we do some white hat hacking. Much as I love to, but it's a bit geeky. So these videos just take you through the process of, okay, you're short fast, yeah, are you fast to lean on your website? I'm not going to go through the video because time's up, but this is what I want to focus on today. Get a verified account. If you haven't got one already, or you're not quite sure what I'm talking about, please come and see me after this, because I'll just go, let's do it now. Let's get you started, get you verified, get that postcard sent to you, so Google knows that you've got a number, you're in their list. That gives that measure of trust. And then do something like buy some storage or something really cheap that gives them, again, another level of trust. I mean, I pay like $12 a month for some Google storage. They give you free stuff. I said, no, I need more. Here's some money. So, yeah, I stay ranked because of those tiny things that allow me to manage my business. Okay, so this is all videos. I'm going to stop here. If you don't want to go through this stuff, you don't need to see it. Happy to play this anywhere if you want to. But in effect, what it comes down to is we're just going to look at some technical things here. Say, is your site found? This is doing a bit of a social media thing. I searched for Tristan McManus, who spoke at the world's biggest networking event at Mystery Round a couple of months ago. Tristan's out there. All this stuff's been collected about Tristan. He hasn't got a website at all. But all this stuff's been collected. Google's presenting him. He knows. Google has connected his son, his wife, all his information has been presented. And he's got a thing on the side there called the Knowledge Panel, which is collected, and in that knowledge panel is Google's understanding of him.
Yeah.
But what I did is I went, oh, Tristan, you haven't claimed your knowledge panel yet, which means I could quite happily, if I wanted to, I could go into Twitter, pretend to be him, claim his knowledge panel,
yeah.
And suddenly I control his account. Well, I actually did this for the next video. I was demonstrating this to the community, and I jumped on and somehow verified myself against a business lawyer. So now I own their site, or at least I control it in some way. It's still to be verified, and someone from that, their email address has to verify that I've basically got access to just randomly looking. So it's open slather. So just be aware of that. Claim your business, make sure you've got not so much locked down, but you know what's going to happen to it. If someone tries to close that business, you'll get an email saying, someone's trying to close your business. You're trapped. Or they've changed your title in your business. Or they've changed your hours of operation to closed. You're not now. So, that's my story. It's not a fear thing, it's just this is the world we're in now. If you're in the digital space at all, you've got a website, you want a website. this area, we maybe go, okay, whole ACT, maybe New South Wales, maybe Eastern Coast Australia. And what we do is we put everything associated with that geolocation information. So whenever Google looks at a photo of you, behind that photo, I can show some stuff about photos, it's amazing what they can do, is all your geo stuff. So every time you're up there, Google's going, oh cool, you're in Canberra. Oh cool, you're in Canberra. So when someone from Canberra's now searching, it's not going to go and go to the UK website necessarily, they go, oh, but local one, that's more relevant. They want to organise the world's knowledge, they want to sell ads. They're not going to sell ads to people who don't want to use them. So they've got this double sword. They've got to be useful to sell ads, which we can leverage that usefulness. Any other questions?
Nancy. So as you were saying, if you're already up coming at the top of this, your Google search, what more can be done to drive more business to your business? I'm wearing my Alan's points hat now.
Well,
thank you. If you put in French language Canberra, we do come up at the tops underneath all the ads. How else can we drive business if you're already coming up?
That becomes one of those, okay, where do you want to be found and what words suit your business that you would be okay having, which may be on page 4 for you, moving that up to page 1.
Yeah.
So it's just more terms in a single website.
Or so waiting to have like our events and things and that's a good idea.
Yeah, because once you're at the top of the game, in a small marketplace like Canberra, where's the competition? In your case, not so much. So like at page 1.
Yeah.
Position 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But every time.
I just got a shout out for David. He looks after all of my SEO. So I just know that I'm covered and safe. So which is great that we meet up so often and go over what needs to happen. So thank you very much for that. Any other question? Or shall we get one more from you, Jill, and then we'll move on to Jamie?
Just a quick one. Once you start implementing all these SEO techniques, how long does it usually take to start?
Okay, this is a tiny demonstration. If you search for 4 words, income protection, Monica, income protection insurance, Monica, those 4 words, you'll see a really dodgy video I did in 2016, like 30 seconds of nothing, that ranked, I think it took 6 minutes to rank to number 1, and stayed under the top of all the larger organisations. And it's a nothing video, but it's real time. So if you're using the right techniques, technically, well, yes, you can rank for minutes. Yeah, because the AI is just looking at everything all the time.
Big brother is watching you. That's
a short answer.
Indeed. It's just a back of what David's saying. We're part of the worldwide network, and the people who do our SEO are in London. They had us up the top, but they had in Monaco, believe it. Local people know Marnica, there's one square shops, the rest of it. So we had to educate them that they had to do the rest of Canberra.
Absolutely.
So it's